I know, that's what I tell him. I'm like, it's pure white teeth.
Hey, Zarno, you're not sitting down anymore. Is that...
Awesome.
I'm sorry.
The avatar is so small, so when I sit down, it gets all
It looks weird.
Up.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kenny, press Control H.
Sorry, sorry, I'm late.
Control
you can't
H
go
gets
fast
rid of
enough
the mic.
Sometimes.
Oh, that's a guest.
Hey guys.
Mega Steak Man is back.
That's awesome.
Which means we'll be getting started here momentarily. Hold on to your butts. Show is going to start soon. We're just double checking the Twitch stream here.
I mute myself.
We are looking beautiful. All these wonderful avatars.
So I think I've sent friend requests to everybody. So if you get booted during the show,
that's a fun avatar.
Just send me an invite and I'll invite you.
You link me to that Sonic model.
Sure. What, this one?
Go on the models.
Oh, you mean the good one over there. You got excited there for a second.
All right. Once that conversation's done over there, we're going to quiet on the set and get things rolling.
Because I believe this is the Generations model.
All right, guys, we're going to start the show. What you're going to want to do is come closer, because I'm sure I don't sound as loud as you want. And Mega Steak Man, can you say a few things?
Testing 1, 2, 3. Can you guys hear me? Is it all around? Everyone can hear this fine? A little quiet?
If it's quiet, come down here and just stand. Or don't stand in front of somebody. Try to work it out.
There are still seats left in the second row on...
But sometimes those are, like, if you're directly across, that still might not be good enough. So yes, you can stand down here if it's too quiet, but some of you can pump up the volume, so definitely do that. So that's first thing, and, you know, muting your microphone is probably the best case, unless you know your microphone situation is good, you're not going to be into it. That would be, you know, super awesome. But I do encourage participating in the show and, you know, cheering and maybe chiming in with something here and there. Of course, not a ton of chiming in, a ton of people taking focus, but do want it to be fun. And then afterwards, we're going to go party. We're going to go to Link to the Past.
Woo!
Overworld map that Mega Steak Man has brought in, which is what we're going to talk about here.
Fantastic.
Yes!
Great.
Yeah.
And disclaimer, Gunter's Universe is intended for entertainment purposes only. All opinions and information on Gunter's Universe are solely those of the host, guests, and the audience, and are not necessarily shared by VRChat and its affiliates. Yeah, I got a disclaimer now. And let's see. Yes. Okay, boom. Boom. Silinkra, you're going to want to go to your menu and put standing enabled for standing. There you go, boom. All right, any last questions? We're about to start. Anybody can't hear? Final warning, final countdown, whoopity whoop. Let's do this.
VR chat, the next frontier. These are the experiences from Gunter's Universe. His continuing mission? To seek out and connect with VR devs and passionate enthusiasts. To discuss theories, beliefs, and rhetoric of all kind. And to boldly go where no show has ever gone before.
Everyone, it's great to see you.
Woo-hoo!
Woo! How are you all feeling? Let's make this Twitter feed. Not Twitter feed, the Twitch feed. People are watching now, showing what our show's about. They may have never been to VR chat, so welcome everyone. Welcome all the new people, all these great avatars around us. It's just getting more interesting, more beautiful every week. Yeah, we do the show every week at 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Pacific. And it's great. You'll notice all these great avatars that have great arm movements, but they can also be a little weird. You might see my arm do something like that. This is completely normal. My arm does this in real life sometimes, and you should not make fun of me for that. That would be rude. Okay. And with me on the show is my co-host, Cause and Effects. How's it going, dude?
Hey, everybody. I'm doing great. How are you doing tonight, Gunter?
Feeling good. Feeling the love. Feeling the magic. And as always, Kenny, he's floating somewhere. K-Dog, he's my cameraman. What's up, Kenny? Yo. And he'll be floating around. He's running the camera system. And it's just, you'll see the green camera flying around. That means he's looking now at me. He may be looking at you. You can smile for the camera. And welcome all the great audience. Appreciate you being here. So our guest tonight is this guy, Sanic. No, actually, that's not. It's Mega Steak Man.
Mega Sanic Man.
Mega Sanic Man. I love it. And your real name is Kyle?
Kyle, yeah.
Kyle. Spell a little differently. That's pretty cool.
That's better than Starbucks does, so thank you.
Yeah, all right. I'm better than Starbucks. Man, my hands will not... You know, they keep doing loser. Loser, you're not losers, guys. I'm just having problems. And yes, you are the, you're doing a lot of things, and we're going to find out more about that, have questions. But I found you through an Upload VR article talking about the Zelda, Legend of Zelda, Link to the Past, world map, VR experiment, fan made experiment that you've been working on hard over the last while. Actually, I don't know how long. Really stoked to have you here and all of that. How are you doing?
Oh, it's an honor to be here. Thank you so much. I've seen the show and I never thought I'd be on it, so I appreciate it.
Oh, yes. Oh, it's great. I love having all kinds of people on the show. I think, we're going to be able to learn some stuff from you, at least feel some of the pain. I think there was some pain going through this. There's a lot of work to do what you've done. And just some of the other work that you've got going on is really cool. I think people are going to be interested. Up there are our video screens. I'm going to play things on them, but it's not the perfect system, so I'm sure I'll stumble around. And also, your partner is VR Mia Darkness. And I think she's the one that I talked to first. She's Melissa, I believe, right?
That's right, M. Lovecraft. She's watching on Twitch. She couldn't. She's at work, so she couldn't join. Well, she could, but, it'd probably be a problem with work.
Yeah. Well, welcome, Melissa. I'm glad you're in the stream. I'm not monitoring the stream from here. Someday, though, we will have the stream, above the table or the chat, and be able to just do all kinds of interacting with that. At least that's my goal. All right, so... Let's just start about, your background, Mega Steak Man. Where do you come from? Where in the world
really,
are you?
I live in Vancouver, Canada, and I actually moved there from the United States. I'm originally born in the United States, and I used to do lots of stop motion. And if you can handle stop motion, I think you can handle just about anything, really. The process of creating, I'm sure there's a lot of creators here, is very tedious. So you have to kind of get used to ideas are fun and fast, but implementing them takes a lot of time.
Well, you're used to fast stuff, Sanic.
Oh, man, yeah, and that's nothing. As in this creative field, you have to go really fast, which is hard because it's a lot of iteration, and, as we'll see with my map, it's not quite perfect, and I keep trying to fix it. But,
and in VR, there's that whole other step of, trying to find the bugs and making sure things are to scale.
Oh, it's crazy. Yeah, you think something's on the floor, but it's not. It's like floating in the air.
Look more about your background. Have you your programming? Did you start with Unity? How far back do you go?
Well, actually, I'm not really a programmer at all. I'm very new to this whole thing, but I'm finding Unity, and actually, I'm using Playmaker as well. Very user friendly. I'm actually impressed that it's fun to code. I didn't think it would be, but sometimes it's fun.
That's awesome. Mostly, a lot of people around here have been, able to get into Unity very easily. Unity is a platform for making games. There are some amazing games made with Unity, but you don't have to make full games. You can make environments. You can make avatars or bring things, 3D models into Unity and port them over to VRChat. It's really, really cool, and that's great to hear that you were learning how to program through Unity and through specifically Playmaker. Can you describe to everybody what Playmaker is in case they don't know what that is?
Yeah, it's basically a visual scripting language. It's a state machine system. So it's kind of like if you can build flowcharts, you can program logic, essentially.
I gotta say,
I've been using the SDK for VRChat. It's very well put together. I gotta say, it's very nice, and congrats to the people working on that.
Sure.
Wonderful work.
Yeah, the team's proud of that, and absolutely. And there's more to come in the SDK. It's just the beginning, and you know, right now there's hundreds of VRChat worlds, and they're just gonna keep getting more interesting, more life to them, and yeah, can't wait. Also, before we continue on, I do want to talk about the Army of Darkness. Could you share a little bit about her and the blog that's going on there and how you guys became partners?
Oh, yeah. Actually, M. Lovecraft's my girlfriend, and we are really into VR. It's such a transformative technology, and we want to kind of promote the best of VR and what it can do. I mean, we love gaming, but we think that it could be so much more. And this is a great example of what you could do with it. That's just not a necessarily traditional gaming application.
So let's show a little bit some videos here. Well, first, I want to show the What is Mega Steak Man 30-second channel promo.
That's so old.
That's too cool.
What is Mega Steak Man?
I think this is over 4 years old.
Unfortunately, no one can be told what the mega steak
and an actor
really need to subscribe for themselves.
Mega steak man. Everybody's gonna be singing that or saying that. Before the web panels may work for some, may not work for some. You may see ads on some. Not much I could do, and I can't turn it up either. So do your best on your end to be able to hear that. But sorry, Mega.
Oh, my friend Kimball actually made a Mega Steak Man 3D model, which I was gonna wear tonight, but it's terrifying. No one wants to see that.
We do.
If you think this is scary, maybe I'll bring it out later.
Yeah. We've seen some scary stuff. We've seen some nightmare fuel in VRChat.
Oh yeah.
You don't want to be around, in the wee hours, like 8 o'clock. It's my time. And just, I'm not going to play all this video, but just, a lot of, what's the name of this? Dumb ways to die in video games.
Yeah, surprise hit. I mean, not my favorite video because it didn't require a lot of, effort from me. It was just, a lot of... And the animation, I did this in, a day, really.
It's the worst animation I've ever done in my life. I'm sorry for that.
We can do that now in real time, right? We could just do this now.
I can't have no foot control, but I'm almost doing it.
Soon, right? The HTC trackers, put a couple on the feet and the waist, I think.
Well, I'm really looking forward to the applications for motion capture and filmmaking inside a computer. Yeah. It's going to be crazy. Actually, that's one of the projects I'd like to do in VRChat, but I just figured it'd be horribly misused by some people. I have a film studio with cameras, and oh no, I've seen Tumblr. I know what's going to happen.
We're certainly going to, do things like that. I mean, VR entertainment is what's going on here, and we
that's
have
true.
Some other performances coming, so... That's what I want to see is actors and theater, right? That's the way we're going to do it. We're not going to record it. We're going to record it, but we're going to be performing it live. And it's just so exciting. This is just baby steps.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. And now what we really want to see is not Mega Steak Man again. what you've made, A Link to the Past.
So when did you start working on this?
This was probably 2015, and I think I spent a week on it, actually. It's actually not designed to be in a game engine at all. It's not optimized. I'm surprised Unity can handle it so well, actually. A lot of N-gons, a lot of things that are just
geometry that shouldn't be there, Well, you'll see.
Yeah, so that's pretty interesting. Because this actually was part of your game of Hyrule, Legend of Zelda,
It's a super cool trailer. I mean, when I saw that, you really blew my mind, to be quite honest, all the
creativity and stuff going on there. You don't expect so much coming from Sanic, you know, it's just so much in there.
Can't contain it inside me, it's just too much.
Too much. So maybe you can... So that this started as that, right? And then it became the VR experience, and you started bringing it to Unity, is that right?
Yeah, and I think it was for a Sketchfab competition, bringing over a model, a Zelda model, into VR. And I've wanted to see these sets because I never thought in my life I would, you know, be able to kind of walk around my 3D models. Like, that just is unheard of to me. And the opportunity to do that is just really mind-blowing. It just, obviously the possibilities, but it's just like, I could never afford to make this in real life. I could never... It wouldn't even be possible for some of these things. But yeah, here I am having the experience as if I was there, which is remarkable.
And you were talking about filmmaking. Like, I think so much, you know, filmmaking is going to be prototyped, right? You have infinite sets and infinite weather, you know, options, infinite terrain, and everybody from the world can join in and make these films. Or at least, I think, instead of storyboarding or the next level of storyboarding before people go out there to the real world. I mean,
oh, for sure. Well, just even that game of Hyrule that you were mentioning, that there are some hard costs on that one. It wasn't expensive, but I probably spent like $5,000 on costumes and just models here and there. But if I made that all on the computer, it wouldn't cost me nearly as much. Like, there wouldn't be those hard costs.
Mm-hmm. So as a filmmaker, much more economical to do things digitally. I have more free. Yeah, the possibilities are endless. It actually only took a few days. So what I did is I animated one object, and then I ran basically like a collider over those objects. And when the collider hit the objects, they would randomly play their animation. So it was a really easy way to control. Yeah, I didn't have like manually keyframe this whole thing. But the render time, sometimes, well, I used the Octane. And Octane is pretty fast coming to Unity, which I'm excited about.
I don't know. Like, there's some... Obviously, you just have to iterate. There's things that don't work. So I'd say probably the video took me another week to animate and code and comp and that kind of stuff.
Cool. And that's just the intro, and there's a 5-minute short that you've done that goes along with that.
That's right. I hope it's good. I don't know. Like, I remember I made Pokemon Apocalypse probably 6 years ago, which was like a gritty, dark Pokemon reboot, and that one blew up. I think it has 12 million views to date. This new Game of Hyrule video, I think it got like 250,000, but like, yeah, YouTube's really changed, so I'm kind of jumping off that platform. It just doesn't seem like the support's there anymore. Maybe the algorithm's changed. Don't know what it is.
So let's talk more about like Unity and some of the difficulties. And maybe some of like more of the assets that you use to make it.
I guess the biggest difficulty was I did not build this at all for Unity. And actually, to get it into Unity, I compressed down each material of a similar type. So all the mountains, just compressed it down. Probably a dumb idea for me to do that, because I was realizing that I put mesh colliders on those. Like, oh yeah, it's a mountain. You can't be able to walk. I'll just put a mesh collider on it. And it would be more optimized to not put mesh colliders on everything, because mesh colliders are heavy. But because everything was like kind of custom made, like every mountain shape is unique, you know, the path of least resistance is just mesh collider. But then there's also trails, which are the same wood texture, which we had problems walking over when we tested it out a few days ago. So there's like unforeseen bugs in that. I'd say, yeah, building things modularly, and which I'm a big fan of from 3D anyways, but that's really important in Unity, I believe, just for file size and usability.
And I think I was reading like some of the assets, like the virtual reality toolkit or Uber. Maybe you can mention more of those. I don't know. You know, share kind of with some of the new Unity guys or people just getting into Unity. I know you're new too, but you might be able to.
Yeah, sure. I'm used to shader development in Octane, and to get a similar look in the one that you, the video you showed prior to that one, the Unity version, I had to use a shader called Uber, which is just brilliant, absolutely brilliant. It gives you a lot more texture channels. So with all these, I didn't really UV map anything. It just kind of like cube mapped everything. And I just wanted it to look generally good, just specifically, like just flat, put a texture on it. And so it just kind of gives the texture more life, having a nice shader. To work off of. I also had AO, I think it's called SSAO. I put on it, and Scion was the screen effects. But yeah, as far as like usability, there's this thing called the Virtual Reality Toolkit, kind of headed up by this guy named Stone Fox, I believe. And it's just crazy. You just drop it in your project and you can teleport around, which I actually used to. I remember my parents showed me a floor plan for this place that they were looking at going to, and I said, oh, I'll just build that in 3D, and well, how do I get around it, because I didn't know how to program anything. I just dropped in the toolkit, you press a button, and you can teleport, and you basically are having a walkthrough of this place that, yeah, you know, hasn't even been built yet. So there's a lot of really cool things you can do with it. Well, you don't even need to know how to program. Back then, I didn't know how to do anything.
Some good tips. So that's...
Actually, I still don't know how to do anything. But...
That's what
when
I say.
Did you
I
start messing
don't
around with Unity?
I'd say probably, I think 180 days ago, I released another game on Itch, which is outside the box. So I probably just like, yeah, maybe like half a year plus, I'd say. Yeah, actually, I'd recommend. Oh, sorry, go ahead. I was just going to say, if you guys are interested in checking out that one, that's kind of fun. It's a puzzle game in which there's a box on the table and you open it up and you see a smaller version of yourself. And it's just like a light puzzle game. It's kind of fun. Free download.
That was my question. What was it about? So
cool. Okay.
And so people can download, they can visit here in VRChat, your map that you've been bringing in here, but they can download it, and it's a little bit different on the Vive. You can, travel above the world, look down at it, or you can get down to scale, like link scale. And that's really interesting. I think people will enjoy that work. You know, be able to find it, and can you talk a little bit about why you chose that kind of locomotion? Or
yeah, sure. And I'm sure we could bring that over into VRChat. I just probably need some help with it because you'd have to actually write code, and I don't know how to do that. I use state machines for that. Really easy flowchart where you just basically say when the right trigger is pressed, detect how big the player is already, and if they're not the maximum size, allow them to get bigger. And I did that because, well, you're so used to seeing these environments from like kind of like this bird's eye view. Mm-hmm. And it's really, I mean, when you're on the ground, it's fairly easy to navigate, but it doesn't give you the same sense of nostalgia as when you're tall. And it's just something really nice about, that view. And I wish I could have a little character running around, little monsters running around too, because just working on it made me feel so nostalgic for that game. That's kind of the preferred viewpoint. That's what I remembered from my childhood. So it was kind of a natural fit. And also just because the environment's so large, like scaling yourself up like that really helps. And I took actually, one of your suggestions was to put a high vantage point that's similar to that bird's eye view in the map, which I've done in the latest version. Unfortunately, parts of it are broken, but you can teleport up to it.
Oh, awesome. That'd be great.
Yeah, I'm just having some problems with the teleporters because the new versions aren't publishing, but we'll work that out later.
Yeah, cool. And that's what all this is about is, it's great for us to test it with you. We can traverse it together and give you feedback. But I do want to take a moment and welcome all the new folks. I see that some of you are just coming in the door. This is great. If you can't hear very well, feel free to kind of line the floor here. As you can see, like Poplopo and Ford here are. Or you can sit in the back too, but you might have a little bit hard time hearing. But yes, welcome. The crowd is even getting bigger, so this is fantastic. And some adorable anime girls over there. It's awesome. So, let's see. When did you get started in VR? When was the moment? What was the first VR headset you tried?
I tried a prototype Vive that my friends are developing a game called Mutato Match, and they invited me over for VR. I didn't know what to expect. I'm sure as most people
just don't know what to expect at all, and you're just like, ah, this will be okay, or you don't really feel like it's going to be as transformative as it is. And I remember taking it off, and just the whole world was different. And I'm sure people felt that weird displaced sense of, like, almost like lucid dreaming, like, what's real right now? And you know, it really impacted me in a cool way. And I knew from that moment on, film wasn't going to be enough. Like, I enjoy making films, and I probably still will make 2D films, but there's something about being in a space and interacting with the space that's just, for storytelling, could be much more impactful and much more fun, I think.
Yeah, it's and then that's kind of a challenge, right? Like, how do you tell a good story in VR? People have been talking about this for a while, and it's not quite solved. What do you have any insights on that? How would you go about, you know, doing your stories?
Well, I've been reading a lot about it, and yeah, as you said, like, it's not quite figured out yet. I think that most people are saying that AI is a big issue, like having AI that can, you know, pathfind to you and is responding to you and in a lot of different contexts. It sounds very difficult. Like, I've been starting to program AI, and it's obviously not easy to do this stuff, but I think that maybe just even scaling back the story ideas might be helpful. Like, I've really enjoyed The Price of Freedom. I don't know if anyone's tried that experience out on Steam, but long story short, you are kind of like a secret agent, and you're going to assassinate somebody, but like, it's kind of somewhere in between a game and a movie, and the cutscenes are dealt with in a really profound and impactful way. I'd highly recommend it.
Yeah, I bet there's some other games out there that are pushing this envelope that I just haven't really even got my hands on. There's so much that's come out content-wise for the Vive and as well as the Oculus Rift. But unfortunately, I spend so much time here, I can't get out of VRChat. It's like, release me. I want help. I'm stuck. It's just, you know, I go to the bar. We have a virtual bar in here called The Great Pug, and I can't escape it because the conversations, the people you meet there, just incredible. How about some other VR titles that stick out, some things you've, you know, thought were interesting or like to play?
Well, I maybe I'm not proud of this, but I really like Sariento. I don't know what the exact name of it, but it's basically you just murdering people over and over and over with samurai swords and guns. And I shouldn't like it, and I feel, man, I'm a bad person, but okay, I'll cut that one up. Oh, man. Oh, there's another guy shooting at me. I guess he deserved it. I don't know. Like, there's a weird thing. Like, I feel strange shooting people in VR. And I don't know. I mean, obviously, there's some weird moral implications and moral issues with it. And I don't know, because I see some people are very flippant about it online. They say, oh, it's a big deal. You know, man up, just shoot. It just seems like not the right.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I mean, obviously, to each their own. I enjoy that game a lot, so I just I'm concerned that I like it so much.
I felt that way. I haven't got to play anything quite as serious as like Onward, which I definitely want to. I'm sure that is pretty insane in that feeling. I mean, I watch videos, but I can imagine. But I've played, you know, I don't know super hot, but they're just not. I don't know what you're playing. If they're more humanoid, they look more human or real, but yeah, super hot. Mm-hmm.
Just like orange figures, yeah.
Yeah, the abstraction probably helps, yeah. But it's really weird. Well, sure. Has everyone here played Accounting VR?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to have any spoilers, but you know the moment. I like running demos of it, and when it gets to that moment, it's really interesting to watch people's reaction. Because some people will pause.
Yep.
Some people just go right for it. It's like, whoa.
Yeah.
I thought I knew you.
It's fun to watch people struggle with that.
That might be a really good way or place to take VR films, is like to have these moral quandaries like that. Like, well, obviously you have to progress, but like, what if you didn't? And yeah, I think this is a very fruitful area right there.
Yeah, sort of choose your own adventure starts coming to mind. That'd be interesting.
It'd be wonderful, yeah.
There's this game, Wilson's Heart, coming out. Have you seen that? It's all black and white.
Yeah, I've seen trailers for it, but I'm not sure. Is that PSVR or is it...
Oculus Rift, and then, oh, I don't okay. know,
I don't think it's probably exclusive for now, or it is an Oculus Studios. So, yeah, all the exclusive stuff, I don't know how it works, you know, exactly. But just as far as they're here, they'll come here in 6 months, and everybody's crying and complaining, I can't handle it. I like what I'm seeing, the creativity, the content, and it really looks like it's going to be, you know, super story-driven. I'm very curious how that's all going to play out. I think it comes out in a few months on the Oculus Rift. Yep.
Well, people are very hungry for that kind of experience. I loved accounting, and I really want to see more of things like that, and I'm trying to develop more narrative myself.
And for those that don't know, accounting is from Squanchtendo, which is Justin Roiland, the creator of Rick and Morty, or half partnership of that. He made it with him and his studio Squanchtendo, which he's partnered with some woman that I can't remember her name, Lisa. Can't remember her name, but just a really cool team. I read an article about them, and just I can't wait to see more. I mean, Squanchtendo right there, it's a great name. And this does make me think of Melissa. I saw on the blog she was painting, she was doing some nail art and had some Squanchtendo art on her nails. Super cool.
Yep. Yeah, we got retweeted, which is like the biggest honor you can get to society. It's like the Nobel Peace Prize or something, getting retweeted by Squanchtendo.
Oh, that's awesome.
Let's see. Well, I was thinking, you know, we could go through a bunch of the, you know, Legend of Zelda titles, talk Zelda, but is there anything else as far as, you know, background or what do you think about VR?
Where did you get the name Mega Steak Man from?
Great question.
Is you like a Mega Man and steak and just kind of like what? Put them together?
No, actually, what's strange, I'm a vegetarian, mostly vegetarian. And I picked the name somewhat ironically in high school when I needed to play Yahoo Pool, because remember that was like really important in the Yahoo account. Like, what's your Yahoo handle going to be? And it kind of stuck. Actually, I was going to get rid of it, but I remember a gentleman from IGN said, the only reason we remembered you from your last video is because your name was so stupid. So I think that's a good reason to keep something.
Love it. What about the potential of VR? I guess you see potential in film, but do you think that VR is going to impact? I mean, we can think about education and get down some of those roads, but anything up comes to your mind or anything that you think of like, wow, I can't wait till VR is doing this or we're able to do that?
Well, that's the weird thing is I actually really enjoy VR right now. Like, people are saying they're waiting for a killer app, but like, it's really wonderful now. Like, it just depends on what you're looking for, I suppose.
Yeah.
But as far as trends, I think that one of the things I've noticed is like, I used to have a lot of VHS tapes, you know, just Kung Fu movies and just, you have these huge collections, right? And then I had to move and I got rid of those. And then I bought some DVDs and then I got rid of those. And then you just kind of like keep getting more and more digital possessions. And I think that's a really good thing because, I mean, even if I lost my digital collection right now, it's not the end of the world. Like, and maybe I'd be upset if I lost my physical things, but just like it frees you up so much to be able to take it with you with VR, like your headset, wherever you go. Like, there's just a lot of great things where you don't need to necessarily own physical things. You can just have these experiences. You can experience them through VR. I think that would just maybe free up a lot of manufacturing, and maybe we just don't need to have so much stuff floating around. And then obviously travel and you can have great experiences Absolutely. With your friends without actually getting on a plane. It's great.
Yeah, less importance on real life things and focus on VR digital goods. But hopefully people will be creating, you know, be part of that creative process with these things, not just buying whatever's on Walmart's shelf or you can order from Amazon. I think that could definitely be help people realize they are creative, because some people just think they aren't, but they might when they can do whatever they want with their hands in any kinds of way. And I think it's also good for people that, like, can't afford shit, right? They can't. Mm-hmm. They're poor. I grew up poor. I wish I had freaking VR then, man. It'd be just brilliant. And for people stuck in the home, so traveling, just reducing that kind of, I think, separation between the haves and the have-nots. I think that's what could be a huge thing.
Yeah, and as you said, like, you can make your own stuff. Like, I could never manufacture the things that I can manufacture in the computer, like, in real life. And it's, I mean, maybe if you had some haptics for whatever it is, like, functionality would be the same. Like, just, I'm still having fun with this thing. So I think there's a great potential in VR to, yeah, as you said, cultivate creativity and just allow these experiences that people couldn't afford it otherwise.
And we can also, you can be with your heroes, like, while Luigi's just over there hanging out. <It's> so cool. And so, you know, people do come here, right? And other guests, they look over and they see somebody that's, you know, a character that they know, and they just, you know, they're such fans over it that it's like going to Disney World or something. They're just kind of blown away. It's adult Disney World, maybe? I mean, not like, well, kids would, yeah, enjoy it too, but it certainly feels that way to me right now.
There's that rapport, like, oh, you know something, there's a common ground, like, you know that thing, I like that thing too, so it's like a good conversation starter, for sure, yeah.
So speaking of, so Zelda, like, big fan of Zelda, is Link to the Past your favorite Zelda game?
I think it is. I mean, it's either that or Ocarina of Time. Although I really like Majora's Mask too. But a lot of people don't like that one. I think that's one of my favorites. But yeah, I've played nearly every single one except for the CDI games. But I'd be curious to hear what everyone else's favorites are. What's your favorite?
Probably one of those two, Ocarina of Time or Link to the Past. But I do have, because not many people either liked it or played it much, was Zelda 2, Link's Awakening. Mm. It was the side-scroller, totally different. You know, played through, you know, all of Zelda 1, Zelda 2, Link to the Past, Ocarina of Time. Didn't play Majora's Mask. Didn't play the Game Boy. My friend had the Game Boy version. I didn't get to check that out. And then Twilight Princess, and that's where I've stopped. I'm just gonna say Link's Awakening, because it was so young.
Oh yeah.
And just the dexterity, like, I love Mega Man so much, so you get to get something like that out of Link's Awakening. Bob here, he's too old.
I played the original from beginning to end, and that's it. But
That's your
game,
favorite.
It's my favorite. I spent so many hours in that. Like, just going back today, listening to, like, the original soundtrack, that it just brought out, like, you listen to the music and it like brings back emotions. Like,
yeah,
when you hear, like, the dungeon track, you're like, I remember when I was little, my heartbeat would go faster when I was in the dungeons, because, yeah, you know, just the emotion in the music would put you into the zone.
Mm-hmm. And then Bob, you went on to computers, you know.
Yeah, it was pretty much like, you know, Apple and Amiga, and then the PlayStations, each one of those. So from there, I didn't really go back to Nintendo until, like, the Wii came out, when, you know, everyone got the Wii. But you know, we just had, like, the kind of like the regular Mario games. Didn't really get into any of the Zelda stuff there.
So you missed SNES. Super Nintendo was awesome. I do have to say, I think that might be my favorite. Part of why I think Link to the Past, still, it's like, it's hard to pick these things. SNES was really good. Mm-hmm. Do you have any of these old consoles laying around?
I think probably 6 years ago, I just sold them just to buy more filmmaking gear. Like, that's another thing, part of the problem, like, you know, how expensive it is, like, all these cameras and lenses. And I do regret it in some ways, but, you know, it also, it just ended up being in a box somewhere. Like, I can't play that every day. So it's probably better that it's out and found a better home than I could provide.
Well, you're making the, your favorite in VR now, so you can go and experience it whenever you want.
That's right. It's better. It's better than it was.
So let's,
do you have any other? Go ahead.
Yeah, you go ahead, Bob. All
right. I was gonna say, is there any other things in VR that you want to make in the future, or you don't know yet?
Well, has anyone here played the game Nightmare? It's a board game that requires a VHS. Yeah. except a few people. It's really dumb. But I have a soft spot in my heart for it because it's just really dumb. And there's like a promise of interactivity, like, you know, you like, oh, it's, you know, the game's, the TV's gonna play along with me. It doesn't. It's just like randomly this guy pops up on the screen. But what if it did? Like, what if like these board games, you're playing a board game, because you can do that now. You can have like a logic where you land on a certain square and like then something happens. And what I'm really interested in trying out is like making like, not necessarily photorealistic, but close, real world environment, so you kind of feel like you're, you know, just sitting at home, and then weird stuff happens in it, kind of like has anyone tried the Cubicle demo? Or it's not demo, it's full experience on Steam. Yeah, I think that's really cool, like just playing in like a somewhat real environment where surreal stuff happens would be a very kind of fun place to explore. I don't want to scare anybody. That's like, I'm so afraid like all my ideas are too horror oriented, because like you can really traumatize somebody.
So I just remember you said CDI and just thinking of like terrible game stuff. So I had a CDI, but and for a poor kid, it doesn't make any damn sense. And I could go into how like Montgomery Wards and all. Anyways, it landed. I mean, I never got the Zelda titles. I wanted to get those, but CDI was just such a whoops. Yeah.
How much do those go for? Because like I'm really shocked at the retro game market. Like I have some Dreamcast games still that like I think they go for like $80. It's like, why?
Wow. I don't know anymore. I think when I went to college, I sold it, you know, and I think it made a couple $100 then, which is pretty surprising.
Yeah. Yeah.
But
I guess that is a downside.
It's rare.
It's very rare.
Yeah, that's probably it.
It's like CDs, man. CD games. This is it. It's basically the future. Like a computer, but a very poor man's computer that hooked into your TV. Apparently, it could be a modem at some point. There's other things to add to it, but. That was the end of it for me. Got any other questions, Bob?
You want to get into some trivia?
No, I'm going to move. Well, yeah, trivia's coming in a little bit, but I want to just sort of go through just some trailers of or some of our least favorite, you know, Link titles or Zelda titles.
All right, cool.
Sure.
Ooh. Wow, this is great.
YouTube's going to kill me. Here having a good time, so yeah, just instantly, right? Story's not much here.
I remember that one.
I missed that sword like the first few times I played the game for sure.
I think I had friends that I was watching first.
Spock here, it's Hylian, you guys.
Alright, let's see what's,
this brings back memories.
Well, I was gonna go on to the second one, but for some reason this was in my queue. Or...
Oh yeah, this is Bratty Link.
Man, I use this exclusively for my set design in the game of Hyrule. Every other thing for
So I love old anime. I love cartoons from the 80s and 90s before they were made with computers, hand drawn. So even though this Link is just the worst. I used to roam the world, monsters and sleeping in mud. That's just kind of the characters that were. Now look at them, living in a castle, in a bed. And like Captain Aren't in the Game I Master, yeah. I mean, you saw Mario. Like that was all a big deal. Reason why I even stay here. Somebody my age at the time, you know, okay, Saturday so morning one cartoons. So if you haven't seen this, you probably shouldn't, but you should. You definitely should.
Yeah, I couldn't even watch this. Looking good, Princess, especially from this angle.
I like the characters do look.
I told you, you should have been on a roof.
guys, it's been a blast.
Cool animation.
But you're going home.
Yeah, it's good animation and like character design is
and
true to the.
And tell Ganon if he really wants this Triforce,
the game,
he'll have to get it himself.
But the voices and the actual
okay,
plots,
that's
the Ganon
better.
Voice and all
that's
that.
How I like to start a
story.
You'll be sorry.
Oh, yeah, it was.
Yeah, it was. This is like a budget Skeletor. You couldn't even afford the real Skeletor.
Obviously. If I want the Triforce of Wisdom, I'm going to have to get it myself.
Yes.
So, yeah, I guess I was playing Zelda 1 at a friend's house, but this was like the first one I bought and sat down by myself and played it. And now an ad popped up my way, man. Get out of my link.
Maybe we'll need a YouTube Red.
Yeah, yes. get a YouTube Red account just for VRChat.
As long as you all have to, it's all local, so you all have to have YouTube Red, and then you probably wouldn't see the ads. So.
Well, I have YouTube Red, and I'm
so you'll
seeing
see,
ads, so it doesn't work.
Well,
like
you're
that.
Not seeing Organa or number one made jewelry.
Oh yeah, some
yeah.
fine gems.
Yeah.
Or you are not.
Yeah,
Marvel Heroes.
It depends where you're at.
There we go.
Yeah. But anyways, hopefully it'll die soon.
Oh, there
yes, might die.
This game was hard.
Very hard. Very hard.
I think it's one of the few ones I haven't beaten. Oh, yeah. If you like Mega Man, this one I don't think I've ever beaten.
I'm proud to say I have. I beat Dark Link. Spoiler alert.
Ooh. This theme song, though, huh?
Yeah. Oh, God, it just brings you back. Because you don't hear this. On any other game.
Smash Bros. Might as well use it. Yeah. Does that guy have no skin? That guy just had no skin. Yeah, but like it looked like he had meat. He looked like he was a meat.
Steak man.
Yeah, he was a steak man. That's obscene. Why would anyone do that?
Full circle.
So yeah, skip through a bit.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, looks like we didn't even move. This is like 10 minutes later. One of the boss, so yeah. You leveled up. You had attributes. You got to decide where you put those. And it was, you know, skill based. Well, not all the others were skill based, but just different. Just had side scrolling. Just different skill.
That guy of a horse head.
Yes. Anyways, I love this one. I'm glad that there's at least one person here that loves this year.
Yes.
But here's probably what I think most people or Ocarina of Time goes to everybody's favorite. And so I skipped through. Aha. Well, we skipped through it a lot. Well, mine's freezing up. Is yours freezing up or playing?
Yeah,
it's frozen.
Mm-hmm.
It's frozen for me.
Oh, it's a good simulation of the pause menu. Oh, skip to the next one.
Yeah, I did just to see if this one works. Yeah, I use a third-party website to play videos. I think I just gave it too much. It's too much power, too much Zelda. There's no way to restart it or anything.
Too much Nintendo power.
I'm using like one of those sync sites, like if you wanted to watch YouTube with a buddy, just your sites. That's actually what's behind
it. That's cool.
Syncing all this in VR is hard. Well, I guess
we can. If I skip around, you see stills, right? Hey, look at that.
Yeah, still. It's like a slideshow.
Yeah.
Cover more ground that way.
Door? Where is
there's a lot
right
of doors.
Yeah. That's
best
what the trivia should be.
What door does that lead to?
So, and it's playing on my local machine, so I know it's definitely like just the panels here, so that's really unfortunate. That means probably all these are busted. Let's see what happens. All these. Well, great show, Gunter. Way to show all the new
Here we go.
Viewers how you can barely play video.
Is it working?
Screenshots.
Screenshots of Breath of the Wild. That was a lot what was last on my list, of course. I'm sure you're all excited about that. Yeah, Supersonic knows what's up. I won't be getting it because I don't play consoles very much anymore, unfortunately. And to buy one for Zelda just... it's sad, you know? It's kind of sad. The Zelda titles dropped off my list because of...
There's a VR rumor about the Switch recently.
Yeah, I don't know what to make of that Switch VR rumor because I don't know if it's powerful enough to really drive a fast frame rate. I don't know. What do you guys think?
I feel like it's going to be like mobile. The Gear VR kind of.
Yeah,
that's true. That's true.
Like a periscope, maybe.
Just the resolution is so low on the device.
Well, I figured out what happened. It was the terrible Link cartoon actually. Just trolling like a virus. So that's the end of seeing the videos. You all should go
watch. There's these great speed runs, right? You ever watch the speed runs? GDQ and stuff?
The Donkey Kong ones are the best. Donkey Kong is crazy. Donkey Kong Countries, Ooh. Oh my god. But yeah, every speedrunner, I don't know.
I played those recently, actually. I love Donkey Kong Country.
Oh yeah, they're fun. They're great.
Beaten those as well. For Donkey Kong Country, the first one, I played it with Nirvana's Unplugged album just constantly, so I cannot separate the two. They're one. That soundtrack, that's the soundtrack for me. All right. How about some trivia, everyone? We've never really done that here with all these people, but... yes.
Yeah.
Motnap, you're just, quiet. For those that are quiet, you won't get called on or we won't hear you as
much, so... good luck. What are the two timelines that split from Ocarina of Time? You guys know about this? Other timelines? I actually got Supersonic raising his hand.
Let's see, we have... there are the three, actually. There's the hero triumphs over Ganon, the hero falls to Ganon, and then there's the child timeline, which split up from the adult timeline.
That is correct. That's a better answer than mine. That's a more correct answer than what I had. I knew there were three timelines, but I couldn't think of the third one. It was like the adult and the child, but then was the other one just things that came before, or did that?
They were just making it up as they went along. They just made it up. I don't think that they're just kind of retroactively trying to make it make sense.
It's kind of cool.
Yeah.
So the next question is... In the original Legend of Zelda on the Nintendo Entertainment System, what does Princess Zelda do to prevent the Triforce from getting into Ganon's hands?
I don't know. You could just say, hey, I got the answer. Or something. And if...
Maybe you stumped us.
Damn the wizard.
I'm going to guess a little bit. She broke it.
Into what?
Three pieces.
Or is it the original? Right. The original is 8, isn't it?
Yep, you are correct. It's 8.
Oh, it's 8. Yeah.
Yeah! There you go. Good job,
it was
Bob.
Teamwork. It was teamwork.
Mm-hmm. name of the ice temple in Zelda the Minish Cap. Anybody played that? You said you played them all.
Ooh.
Who's that? Mechle?
Oh, I don't know the names of the dungeons.
Or Botna?
Cap is great. I think it's better than the...
The one that we've been talking the most about tonight. That there's nobody funnier in VRChat than Motnap, so you should all get to know him, friend him, harass him. He likes it. Anybody played Minish Cap and maybe can answer that question? Back here? Darny Whoop, you got an answer?
I was just sending hearts, because I love that game.
So you have some love...
off the top of my head.
How about the Temple of Droplets?
I love it.
Remember the
Temple of Droplets.
Temple of Droplets. Apparently, that's the answer. I did not know that either, but I wanted to include some various ones that I didn't know.
Next one is, what is the sixth Zelda game made?
So I got this far at least.
Yeah, sixth game in the series, or that's made.
Oh my goodness. Why are you a chip?
First person, anybody? No.
We can talk after the show.
Just talk, just say it.
Okay. Was it Oracle of Ages / Seasons?
No.
Negative.
Mega, you can feel free, anybody? No. There's a hint. No, there's a hint behind me, I think. No, it's not. Actually, that's a different game. You already said that. Sorry. It's one that I haven't really played, so.
Ocarina.
I think there's a hint over there. There's a hint back there in the back. Yes.
Yeah, I'm the hint.
He's the hint. He knows it. The hint's on his face. The hint's Majora's on mask. His face. Majora's Mask, it is. Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Look on his belt there. He's dressed for the occasion. Oh, and behind we have the Master Sword. Olivier is excellent. He's the one who built this set, designed, built it here.
Oh, nice.
We love him. He's been here for years. Met him, hung out in California, partied down, met Palmer, kissed him on the... No, I didn't. What's up next, Bob? Did I read that one or you read that one? You read that one, so I'm up next.
Yeah, you're up next.
Well, I think if anybody remembers, the first Zelda to introduce Dark Link... Damn Wizard, you can't answer this one. What was the first Zelda?
No,
shut up.
It.
You can't say that every time. No. Who's got it?
Right here.
What's your name? Oh, is that Psycho?
Psycho. Yeah, Link to the Past 2. Not Link to the Past. Zelda 2.
Yes, Link's Awakening, as I mentioned earlier, having beat Dark Link, which is crazy hard because he really mirrors and does a lot better than you, so it's brutal.
Next up is, how many days do you have before the moon falls in Majora's Mask?
Just say it out. Oh,
three.
He already did.
Yes.
Yeah, he had his hand correct. Up. All right, nice. How many bosses are in A Link to the Past? Mega.
Oh, man, that's tough.
Or anybody else?
There's four dungeons in Light World? Three? No, there's three in the Light World. Ah, gosh, maybe eight? No, seven.
Nope, more.
Like 12.
More.
More.
Wow. Are these like mini bosses as well as bosses?
More than
or...
12.
Is that like the wizard at the beginning counts as well?
Oh, right. Yeah, Ganon.
You're not going to. You can't ask any questions. You just have to answer and be right on what I have on my notes. 13. 30? No, 13 is the answer. I'm going to say, I'm going to pretend you said 30.
Yeah.
Okay. 13. Absolutely. I don't know. You should know. You know now.
Yeah, I should have.
Okay, who is next question? Who is the first boss in Link to the Past?
Aragorn.
Can I answer?
I can't remember his name.
Nope. It's hard to hear you. Come closer. No.
And would the brass knuckle be considered a boss? Or I'm not sure what the name of the Morningstar kind of guy is. Probably
the Iron Knuckle guy?
Oh, yeah. Iron Knuckle, yeah.
Nope.
Sounds like Aragorn or Era. Aghanim? Aghanim, that's it.
Nope, he's a knight.
Oh. Oh, yeah, like the little hopping knight guy. I just don't know his name.
Yeah, in the very beginning.
They come out with their bow, splitting into multiple knights, and they jump in patterns.
They kind of look like clansmen, so maybe they're clansmen? I don't know.
Armos.
Oh, okay, Armos. Right, Armos. Armos. I should have known that I sculpted one for my project.
Well, I'm glad you guys are being stumped. This is good. These are good trivia. I was worried that I haven't played them all. So cool. In Ocarina of Time, where do you fight Ganondorf? Easy. Fight him.
In
Hyrule's castle.
No.
Hyrule castle.
In Ganon's castle.
Yes. Ganon's castle. It's Ganon's
castle. Woohoo.
Alright. Next is, who is the young Rito prince who has not yet gotten his wings and wind wings?
Young Rito prince, Wind Waker. Who is the young Rito prince? What's his name? I played a little bit of Wind Waker. No. And I watch Everyday VR stream, do his stream of playing Wind Waker. He did the whole thing in VR. Many, many chapters, many segments.
Oh, wow. So, like, seeing a little Link running around? Like, that's crazy.
Oh, yeah, like through the Dolphin emulator?
You can I want to try that. I would love that.
It's great.
Yeah?
Just don't try and play Sonic Adventure in VR. Just
I'm going to. I am. I got to. Gotta go fast.
You say, don't do it, and he says. So I'm just going to give the answer. Komali.
Komali. Oh, yeah.
It was Komali.
Cool. Sorry, Bob. That was actually your answer. Who created the Legend of Zelda series? Creator.
Miyamoto?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Who is the Miyamoto? First boss in Ocarina of Time?
Oh.
Yeah, go.
You can just shout him out.
Right, that's right. Yep. Queen Goma. Nice. Mm-hmm. By the way, I don't know. They said it. It's so fun to put them to you guys. In Link to the Past, what general area do you get the Bombus medallion? General areas.
Bombus. Oh.
Super.
Wasn't that in the desert? Was that where you got
yes.
the Bombus?
Yes. Desert of. Desert of Mystery.
Oh.
Close. Pretty damn close. You're definitely. You know your Zelda shit. Supersonic.
I try.
In Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time, what is the name of the Zora princess?
Rudo. Rudo.
Yep.
Correct.
Got it.
Rudo.
Two more. Where do Gorons live in the Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time for N64?
Death Mountain.
Death Mountain.
Yep. These two guys.
They know what's going on.
You guys got to get last. This one question. Probably everybody knows.
Yeah.
See if you can get it in before these two.
What is the horse's name?
Epona.
Epona.
Nice.
Epona. Yay. I think that was pretty good.
Yeah, Twilight Princess.
Yeah, well done, guys.
It yourself.
Yeah. It's great.
There's some hard players on the fence here.
Mm-hmm. Well, you guys will have to point out all the errors in my map, because I'm sure you'll find them.
Yes, we're going to go through a fine-tooth comb and absolutely do that, right? We got the crew to do it tonight, man. This is going to be great.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a few VR chat news that I'm going to go through quickly, and then we'll do some plugs and end the show. Coming up Thursday, and as far as VR chat, we're doing more events. These things are starting to happen, and what we need is, though, is in-game way to tell when events are happening and synced up with our website. So none of that's happening right now. What you could do is just be in our Slack group, and I do events, so get to know me and follow Gunter's Universe. That helps you stay in tune, and then we will have the appropriate systems in soon because we want people to go to these events, right? And you guys want these events. So Thursday in the Great Pug at the same time that this show starts, 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Pacific, is an acoustic performance by McMuse. Brady McKenna goes by McMuse.
Nice.
He's freaking really good. He likes to play in virtual worlds. And he's playing across all the VR, social VR apps, or some of them, including like High Fidelity, AltSpace, and here, and who knows where he'll go next. But he is making it a regular thing, maybe every 2 weeks, he was saying. So he'll be performing a lot. That's on Thursday. That will become, all these events are invitation through getting in contact with me, being on Slack, following the Twitter, and also in GuntersUniverse.com, the mailing list. That's where I'm shooting out, saying, who wants invitations? That's the only way we can really do it right now until we get some other tools in. Then we will do it differently. And last week, we had this audio-visual experiment that PK, if you ever see him around, he's in Vancouver, and he has a music label and does all kinds of cool stuff like that, knows a lot of Sketchfab people, too. It was really rad. All kinds of his own music or his friend's music, dropping a record down. It's not spinning yet, but just throws it down, it plays a track. Then he's got a board and toggles all this crazy backgrounds and just really psychedelic and interesting things. He'll be doing that maybe again this Saturday. Stay tuned on Slack. I think he's trying to get this worked out and working better. And if you go onto my Twitter, you'll see a retweet of some clips from that. Cool.
It was crazy.
You were there. Yeah, you were there.
Highly recommended if you guys can check that out.
Super, super cool. And he's really going to be like, he'll be iterating on this. He's super serious about it. He's bringing live DJs here at some point. He's asking a lot of questions, wants to know how to make his dream come true in here. And also we have just, we've added to VRChat Intel 7 core. 4 or 5 million. He's powering VR chat right now.
Yeah, careful, don't break it. Yeah. You can break the chat. No.
Don't overclock too high.
Just a couple more announcements. There's new VR chat games or versions of our Steel and Gold called Miner's Dispute and our CTF, Capture the Flag. We now have Blast Factory. These have grenades in them now. It's really cool. VRChat is constantly working to get new, fresh content here, new levels for these games, and so excited about that. Keeps bringing people out. Make sure to check those out. Group up, find friends, have fun. And a final announcement that I would love to happen is when you see mods, hosts, same thing right now, thank them. Just go up and thank them. Give them a hug, man. These people are working so hard. And they're actually in disguise sometimes because it's just like, I can't take it. I got to, it's hard. I've modded a lot, and it's just like, I got to take a break. I'm happy there's the pug and the pub. It's just really important right now. We really are, this group of people are holding things together. There's just been an explosion of users, which is why there's so many of you here. But there's also some undesirables and people have manually been taking care of that, including this guy over here, VR Pill. He just, boom, you're done, you're not, uncool. Of course, it's not quite that strict, but, mainly in our hub area, like to keep it clean, because you never know, young people there, all kinds of people, it's not safe. So there'll be the right tools, though, to help us take care of those things so that the mods don't have to do this, but please thank them and think of this, like, we're all the community. This is all our clubhouse. This is all our place. Let's all set the example. Maybe one time we should all just be in the hub together and we start showing how it is that how you behave in VRChat, right? This is our place. We don't want some dominant group of aggressive people just trying to take over and set the cultural norms in this place. No. Don't run away to private rooms. We're going to fix this. We're going to take control, keep control, and keep VRChat cool.
You heard that?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
Hold on. A few more things. Yeah. One more. Or Phil, do you have anything to add, or are you just like, yes?
I'll wait until you're done streaming to add something, but
sure. We'll go through that, and then so I want to give. Down, that's right. Secrets. You have to come into VRChat to learn that.
It's a secret to everyone.
Megastick Man, where should we point people to? Your Twitter, your website.
Probably Twitter might be the best because I still have a YouTube channel, but I might not be as active on it. So Twitter would probably be for new games and experiences. I'd recommend Megastakeman at Twitter.
And go check out his videos. They're awesome.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, they're hilarious. It's great. And thanks to the Army of Darkness. Follow her too. Mm-hmm. And just that blog is really cool. Chock full of all kinds of cool stories and seems to be active, so that's great. And then I'll turn things to Cause and Effects. He is also co-host of the Left-Handed VR podcast.
Yep, so we are, yeah, we're recording. Shout out to Matt, who is
Holotape. He's watching on Twitch right now. He was here earlier.
Oh, yeah. Matt, what up?
So we're going to be recording a new episode on Sunday. And so that'll be out, you know, probably sometime next week. And you can follow us at LHVR Podcast on Twitter or Facebook. And we're on all the popular podcasting platforms.
Yeah, these guys are old. They've been around for years. Huge library of content, and it's hilarious. These guys are good friends. They're funny. They know a lot about VR. Check them out. It's good stuff. And I don't have to say anything more about me. I'm Gunter. Gunter's Universe. Check it all out. Keep staying connected. Thank you guys very much for attending the show. Everybody that's watching the stream, my team here, VRChat, Pill, the moderators. I'm going to stop now. Love you guys. Good night. And boom.
Yeah.
Woo! All right.
We did it.
All right.
Yeah, now we can dance. Now
there we
stand
go.
Up.
Somehow, I don't know.
The Intel,
right.